Hello. Good morning. How are you this morning? I'm born again. Love the Lord as my personal Savior. Mrs. Pastor Mark from Temple of Worship Ministry, just behind Kasmat Supermarket here in Mwiki. I am glad that the Lord made me see another day. Marvin, some cold, my voice is not good, but I thank God that I am able to stand before the congregation, even stand before you, my viewer, to glorify Jesus. Today is a very special day for our youth. We are having our worship experience organized by the youth in the ministry from 2 to 5. If you are around this place, if you can travel from afar, please I extend my welcome to you, that you may come, we worship Lord together with you. And now, as I've always told you, that our services are as follows. From morning, we have from 9 to 10, we have our intercessory hour, where we come, we pour our hearts before the Lord, we pray for our families, pray for our country, we pray for anything that is disturbing you, and I tell you, that's how we receive our miracles. We have our main service from 10 to 10:30. Please, if you're around, please just come and hear what the Lord has for us this day. I know it shall be great, impactful, and powerful. The Lord shall do us good. Wow, now it's another time that has come for us to hear from the Lord. We have our dad, the ministry, the founder of Temple of Worship, even the international speaker, as I always call him, because he is. You know, he has listened from the Lord. He has a word from the Lord. And even my heart is prepared to receive from the Lord. So you have. But before he comes on the heart, I want you to do something. Please be my ambassador out there. Be my hasha. Share this link. Just subscribe to our channel. Like, comment and say something, and we will be glad to receive what you are saying. The Lord shall do us good. So I want us to put our hands together as we appreciate, as we welcome the man of God. Karibu Mchungaji Mark, we want to hear what the Lord has this day. God bless you and shalom. Amen.
Well, praise the Lord and welcome once again to the house of God. We want to go straight to the word of God. But before that, I want to welcome you to this program. Please subscribe to our channel. Say the word of encouragement, and the Lord is going to bless you. You are free to share the link with whomever you want, so don't feel constrained by anything. Please share, and the Lord is going to bless you. If you want to get in touch with us in terms of support for the ministry, you typing and giving, sowing a seed, you can do that. I will share the number. The number is 07-04-519-274. I repeat, the zero is 07-04-519-274. And the Lord is going to bless you. We have received many testimonies of what the Lord has done to the people that have been supporting to this ministry, and we want to invite you to be part of this ministry through your support, and the Lord is going to bless you. Amen. Well, the Bible says, man shall not live by bread alone, so we want to go to the word of God. The time with me, I'm going to read only one verse in the Bible, the book of John, chapter number 12. If you have your Bible, please stand with me to the book of John, chapter number 12. And I'll read verse 24. John chapter 12 and verse number 24. I'm reading from Amplified Version of the Bible. The Bible says, I assure you, most solemnly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just one grain. It never becomes more, but lives by itself alone. But if it dies, it produces men on earth and yields a rich harvest. Shall we pray? Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray this morning. Pray the Lord, your word is going to be a lamp to our feet, Lord. Your word is going to encourage us, King of glory. Your word is going to teach us how to relate with you. Your word is going to teach us how to understand your thoughts towards us, O Lord. I thank you, Father, and I bless you. As I share your word, Lord, I submit to you, Lord, humbly that, Lord, you may use me as a vessel. But the glory and the honor belongs to you. I give you honor and I give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen. Somebody say amen. Well, as you have heard, we have a worship experience. We're going to be rocking this place with fire. This place is going to be on fire from 2 o'clock. Please make your way here. You will not be disappointed. Everything is going to be fire. And I want also to announce this to the people that are watching, that on 19th of next month, we're going to have a special service here. 19th of December, we're going to have a special service. We're going to have a Thanksgiving service in this place. We're going to give a special offering for the year. We're going to also partake of the Holy Communion in this place. And we're going to dedicate all the children that have been born here in the ministry and have not been dedicated. And if you are out there and you want your child to be dedicated, please get in touch with us. We would love to dedicate your child and issue a certificate to you for dedication. Amen. So mark the date is 19th of December 2021. We're going to have those three things. We're going to have much worship as we say thank you to the Lord for the whole year. So it's going to be a Thanksgiving Sunday where we're going to have a lot of praises and worship in this place. Then we're going to partake of the Holy Communion. Holy Communion is holy and it belongs to Christians. So if you are born again, you qualify for the Holy Communion. Amen. And after that, we're going to dedicate the children to the Lord. And we're going to issue them with the certificates. Amen. 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 Well, I want to turn to where we have read. We have read something that Jesus was talking to his disciples. And he told them that most assuredly, I tell you, unless the grain of wheat falls on into the earth and dies, then it remains just itself. But if it dies, it produces others and it yields a rich harvest. And I want to talk to you about watering the seed. A seed is a unique thing. And I know when I talk about the seed, people think about many things. But yes, I am talking about the seed that is planted in the soil. I know that this country, most of the people are involved in farming or are involved in farming at one time of their life. And you understand the power of the seed. If you get a good seed, then you put it in the ground. If you get 1 kilo of maize and put it in the soil, then it doesn't produce 1 kilo of maize. It produces probably 100 kilos, because seed has an ability to multiply. Seed has an ability to multiply and bring a great harvest. But for seed to do this, it needs to get into the soil and die. You know, the seed cannot produce. The Bible says if it remains alone, it doesn't die. It lives. If it remains not in the soil, then the seed remains alive. It doesn't die. It lives. But when it gets in
into the soil, the Bible says it dies. And when it dies, it produces a rich harvest. And I want you to understand that the dying of the seed and the harvesting of the seed, those are two different things. The Bible talks in the book of Genesis that as long as the earth liveth, seed time and the harvest time shall not cease. So a time to plant will always be there, and a time to harvest will always be there. So those that plant will surely reap. If you don't plant, you don't reap. You cannot reap where you did not plant. That's what the Bible says. You cannot harvest where you did not sow. But this is not what I wanted to talk to you about. I wanted to talk to you about the watering of the seed. Because you can put the seed in the soil. And when I talk about seed here, I'm talking about your destiny. Your destiny is your seed. You can put your seed in the soil. And I want to submit to you that putting the seed in the soil is actually concealing the destiny. That time you are concealing, you are hiding the destiny of the seed. We cannot see the seed because the seed is going to die. So it is a destiny concealed. The moment you plant your seed, you are concealing the destiny. And the time of the seed coming out as a harvest, I call it is a destiny review. So there is a concealing of the destiny, and there is a revealing of the destiny. That means the seed dies, you cannot understand the destiny. But when it grows up, then it reveals the destiny. But let me tell you, between the concealing of the destiny and the revealing of the destiny, there is a period called watering period. If you do not water the seed that you plant, however healthy the seed was, the seed will not germinate. If you put it in the wrong soil, the seed, that's what the Bible talks about, the seed will not germinate. But if you put it in the right soil and water it, that time when you're watering, the destiny is still concealed. But when it comes out because of watering, then the destiny is revealed. And let me tell you something. Many people here listening to me are going through a time of watering. A time of watering is not a comfortable time. A time of watering is not a time to rejoice. A time of watering is not a time for happy. A time of watering is a difficult moment for everyone, because it's a time of death. It's a time that the seed has died and the destiny has been concealed. And I believe I am talking to somebody whose destiny looks like it has been concealed. I believe I am talking to somebody who cannot see the end to their life. I believe I am talking to somebody who is going through trouble. I believe I am talking to somebody who is going through rejection. I believe that I am talking to somebody who has been looking forward to get a child. Probably I am talking to you and you do not have an income. I'm talking to you. You don't know how to put food in on your table. I am maybe talking to you and your ministry is not thriving day after day. I want to submit to you, you are going through a watering period. The destiny may be concealed, but I want to tell you something. A time is coming after the seed dies. A time is coming when the seed is going to bring a mighty harvest. A time of revealing the destiny is coming. The time to reveal your destiny is coming. So don't worry, even if you pass through temptations and trials. Don't worry, even when you are going through hardships. Don't worry when people reject you. Don't worry because of the situation that you are passing through. I want to tell you, it's a time of watering. And your seed is going to grow. Maybe you have put your tithe in the church. Maybe you have put your seed in the church. Begin at the part of the Kanisani. Begin on the Torah Sadaka Kanisani. Begin umelipa fungu lako la kumi kanisani, lakini mambo yako bado haijabadilika. Nataka nikwambie ni wakati wa kunyunyizia maji. The Bible says give. When we give water to the seed, the Bible says give. And when you give that water to the seed gives it back to you. So the principle of give and it shall be given back to you. When you give the drizzles of water, then the seed is going to give you back a mighty harvest. So what you are going through, the trials you are going through, the feelings you are going through, the rejection you are going through, the broken relationships you are going through, the troubles in the marriage you are going through, I want to say to you this day, that it is a time of watering the seed, and the seed is going to give you back what you have given. So keep your hope alive. Don't lose hope. Don't give up on anything. Don't give up on your life. Don't give up on your family. Don't give up on that relationship. Don't give up on that business. Don't give up on that ministry. Keep holding. God is going to reveal the destiny, because you have already sowed the seed. Somebody say amen. This is something that has been burning in my heart. Something that has been bubbling in my heart. And the Lord revealed to me before I came here. The Lord revealed to me. That's why I don't even have notes. The Lord revealed to me that there are people that I'm going to be talking to today who are going through a watering period. Who are going through a period that looks like it's a dry period. Who are going through a period of desert. Who are going through a period, a moment of trials. And the people are giving up. Some of them are in the verge of giving up. Some of them are in the verge of blaming every situation around them. Some of them are feeling like salvation is not working. Some of them are feeling like going to see a witch doctor. That they want to go and get to understand what is happening. I want to tell you, just hold it there. It's a moment of watering. It's a period. You cannot sow a seed today and harvest tomorrow. You cannot do that. Even if you put me, the Bible says there is a period of dying. Death will happen to the seed for it to sprout, for it to come up with much harvest, for it to give you back. There is going to be a moment of death. And when there is a moment of death, then there is also going to be a moment of watering. You got to water your seed. And I want to tell somebody today what you are going through. The trials you are going through, those are waters. The rejection you are going through, those are waters. The joblessness that you are going through, those are waters. The troubles that you are going through in your business, those are waters. And I want to tell you something. God is going to reveal your destiny in a moment, not too long. So don't give up. The seed is going to the soil. It's already there. Watering period is a difficult period, because even the soil doesn't know whether the seed is still there or the seed was taken by the predators. They most of the time when you put your seed in the soil, sometimes you actually don't know whether the seed is already there. Ama imechukuliwa na sungura, ama imechukuliwa na msongaleni, ama imechukuliwa na squid. You don't know until it starts coming out and it brings forth much harvest. So you may feel like you have lost it, but I can tell you, you are not lost it. You are not losing it. You are not losing anything. You're not losing anything. It's a moment of watering. It's a moment of the death of the seed, but much harvest is coming. So I want to speak to those people. If you are there and you are giving up on your marriage, I want to speak to you. Your marriage will survive in the name of Jesus. You're going to enjoy your marriage in the name of the Lord. Maybe I'm talking to you, the person I'm talking to. You are sick and you are giving up on your sickness. I want to tell you, healing is coming your way in the name of Jesus. The seed is sprouting in the name of Jesus. Probably I am talking to you. Ministry, and you're just about to hang the boots. You're saying enough is enough with this ministry. I am not seeing it growing. I am not seeing anything. I came to tell you today, just hold there. God is going to reward you with a mighty harvest in the name of Jesus Christ. Don't give up. It's a moment of watering. It's a moment of watering. It's a moment of watering. I feel like there are people that are watching. Their marriages are in the verge of collapse. I speak to you in the name of Jesus that your marriage is going to survive the trials. Your marriage is going to be more enjoyable than even when you first met. There are people whose businesses are going down. They are blaming it on Corona. Let me tell you something. It may not even be Corona. It is the seed that died, but it is coming out to give you a mighty harvest. I prophesy to that business that you are going to make much profit in the name of Jesus Christ. Your health is coming back. Your children are coming back. Your income is coming back in the name of Jesus. The moment of watering is over. The moment of watering is over. I pronounce to you, the moment of watering, the seed is over. And Jesus is giving you victory from this month. God is going to give you victory in the name of Jesus Christ. You're going to flow in the abundance. You're going to enjoy the abundance of the blessings of God in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, that's prophetic, and I want to pray with somebody today. You're there, you're saying, Pastor, indeed, I'm just about to give up. I want to pray with you. You're there, you're saying, Pastor, I'm so discouraged by the work that I'm doing. I want to pray with you. You are there, you are saying, I'm just about to lose my job. I want to pray with you. You are there, you are saying, Pastor, I don't know how I'm going to make the end meet. I just want to pray with you because God is going to turn things around to your favor in the name of Jesus Christ. If you are there, just believe God with me. I want to pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I want to pray for my viewer. They're going through difficult moments, but they understand now it is a time of watering. I pray that the watering peak comes to an end in the name of Jesus. Release your anointing upon them in the name of the Lord. Release happiness to that family. Release joy to that marriage. Release profit to that business. Release promotion to that job. Release health to that sickness in the name of Jesus Christ. And I pray on today that the people who have heard this message and I believe are going to walk in the abundance because their destiny is going to be revealed in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray this by faith in Jesus' name. Amen. Probably you're there, you're saying, Pastor, I don't know the Lord. I want to give my life to Christ. You're there, you're saying, you want to give your life to Christ. I want to lead you to the prayer of repentance. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you. I repent of my sins. Forgive me. Write my name in the Lamb's book of life. I believe in you. And I will follow your instruction in Jesus' name. Well, if you are praying that prayer, well, believe in your heart that you are saved. And you are going to remain strong. Hook yourself with a church near you. You can come here to Temple of Worship. We would love to minister to you. If you can find your way here, you're going to be blessed. And God is going to bless you. Otherwise, I leave you with the word, Shalom. We shall meet next week. God willing.